episode 2339, The Meeting of Two Personalities.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy B-Day. I hope you're having a fabulous weekend. It is Relationship Builders, and I want you to focus on your spouse, building a foundation with the person that you love the most. But you know what? What happens when two people come together? You definitely have the meeting of two personalities. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. Carl Jung said this: the meeting of two personalities is like the contact of two chemical substances. If there is any reaction, both are transformed. Where in your dating and courting did you discuss your personalities? Think back for a minute, because I know I did not sit down with my husband and say, "Sweetheart, what type are you? Are you type A, B, C, D?" Some of you may know of the DISC personality. There are so many different personality tests out there. They're strength finders. But at what point did you say, "Let's talk personality"? Because most of us talk about our dreams, how many kids we want to have, and where we want to live. But looking at personalities directly is rarely a topic of discussion. So what if you did look at your all's personalities? Do you think that would change anything? Of course it would. Why do you think marriage is so challenging? You are doing life not only with another individual, but one with a unique personality. When you connect two unique personalities, there are definitely sparks. So honor the transformation. That is your kiss to keep it simple strategy. Honor the transformation. Jung had it. He knew. He said, it's like two chemical substances. If there's any reaction, both are transformed. But what's unfortunate is we get married, we're done with the dating, we're done with the courting, and we think, guess what? Now let the change begin. But the change that we're searching for is what we want to see in our spouse, how we want to make them. Don't try and hide what does happen when you get married and as you continue doing life together. Honor the transformation, both for yourself and your spouse. So what does that look like? Number one, see your spouse for who he or she is becoming. This is vital. You know, your heart needs to pump in order for you to be alive. Yeah, this is what needs to be pumping for your marriage to be alive. You've got to see your spouse for who he is, who he's becoming. Transformation is what? It's change. So it's important to understand that your spouse is not going to stay the same just as you met him. When you met your wife, has she been the same? No, she even changed since birth. Ask whoever raised her, her mom, her dad, her grandma, her auntie. Transformation is change. It happens. That is our constant in our life, is change. So when we marry someone, we have to understand, you know what? They're not going to be the same. Because it would look a little strange if you married a baby. I mean, come on. Let's have a little bit of comical relief here. Now, yes, this is important to talk about, but we need to understand that we're not going to look like we were as an infant. And praying that we have a very long life, we're also not going to look like what we did when we first got married. So there's always change happening. And it's important for us to understand that with our spouse. Give them that grace. The thing is, be able to let them have that space to become who they are becoming. Let them fill in the missing spots. Have you ever laid sod? I know this is probably totally crazy and out of the blue, but I'm going to tell it anyway. We have beautiful grass, but unfortunately, the way our house sits. It's a circle driveway, and our delivery trucks, which don't come too often with the exception of the mail truck, but they come enough. And unfortunately, during our snow time, just a few months ago, we had like 16 inches of snow down here. It was crazy. If you listen to a lot of my episodes, you probably heard me talk about it. Well, unfortunately, our grass did not survive very well. You couldn't see where they were, the grass. They didn't know where the driveway was, but they ran over some areas and really mauled down the grass. I mean, more than mowed it over. And then we also had landscapers that didn't do a really good job at the end of the season. And they came when it was wet and their heavy, heavy mowers just beat it into the ground. So spring arrives and guess what? I've got beautiful green grass except in this spot. And it wasn't just a little spot. It was a good size spot. In fact, it needed a lot of attention from me. It needed sod. And I was like, oh, I've laid sod before, just in little places here and there that you need to do it. But you have to be able to do it right. And guess what? It also has to have time, what, to grow to the ground in which you lay it on. And you got to prepare the ground. Well, just like laying sod, the same thing goes with our relationships in marriage. We have to be willing to till the soil. We have to be willing to plant. We have to be willing then to water and care for it. We have to be willing then for what? Change, the transformation to occur, for the roots to take ground, then for growth to occur. And then what do we have to do? We have to prune it. And then what happens again? It grows again. We have to prune it. We have to water it. We have to care for it. We have to fertilize it. Yes, believe it or not, sod does match up with our foundation in marriage. It's crazy. So when you're looking at your spouse, you've got to see your spouse for who he or she is becoming. And then number two, you got to lead with patience. When you lay that sod, does it just happen overnight? No, I'm going to tell you right now it doesn't, because I have seven pieces that not all of them took well. Some of it turned brown and I'm waiting for this other sod to come in so I can go replace them. I'm going to have to cut out areas that did take and I'm going to have to replace the brown ones that killed the other good grass, which really wasn't there, but there was just enough that it may have come back, but I needed to build it up. So it's okay, but now I'm still going to have to do double, triple the work. Well, guess what? I got to be patient with it. I didn't get the result the first time, but that doesn't mean that it's not going to take. Change takes time and is a process. So don't set expectations as to when someone is supposed to be something for you. When I lay that sod, those roots have got to take ground. Because what happens if it doesn't? You know what happens. Yes, it dies. And mine did die. In some areas, not all areas. And this is in a different portion of the yard. The trucks didn't go through here. That's not it. It just needed to be built up a little bit. And we had some dry areas. And I thought, okay, we're going to just put sod here this time around. And it worked in some, but didn't work in others. And so now I'm having to take out and transition back into newer sod, which is going to take more time. I'm like, seriously, but I have to be patient. We all have to be patient when it comes to change. And we have to understand that change is that constant and we've got to honor it. And finally, number three, give the gift of you. And you're like, how does that even match with honoring the transformation? Who you are becoming matters too. We think about our spouse, but we forget about our own reflection. You have to be willing to look in the mirror and accept the process of transformation for yourself. Yes, believe it or not, you're a piece of sod. You have now been told you're a blade of grass, a beautiful blade of grass, but one that's going to go through a transformation in a lifetime. And you're going to change and you're going to grow and you're going to have to be pruned and you're going to have to be fertilized. Yes, you're even going to have to be spoken to so you can grow and be pruned again and be watered and fertilized. But when you look at yourself, you have to be willing to give the gift of you, who you are becoming. Marriage is not easy, but it is an adventure. Look at it that way. Every single day is new. Just yesterday, my husband said, "You're crabby today." And I said, "No, I'm not." He goes, "Oh, no, no, no. Yes, you are." And I thought about it for a moment. I'm like, guess what? Maybe I am crabby. If I've had the crazy week that I've had, isn't it okay to be crabby for maybe 15 minutes? Because really, I do try to hold it together most of the time. So if I'm crabby for just a moment, okay, deal with it. Now, I didn't say that, but in my mind, in that 3-something seconds that I had, yeah, that was the whole scenario in my head. I'm just being real with you. But I thought, yeah, maybe I am a little crabby. And not that I was being mean, I was just being a little bit short. So I backed off and thought, okay, keep the conversation light. And if you don't want to participate, just keep your mouth shut. And I was fine the rest of the night. We were fine. Everything was great. There was nothing wrong with that. It was just that for whatever reason, I just needed some of me to be out there. I needed to be crabby. And not to anybody, but I was just like, just leave me alone and let me be. We have to be willing to embrace each other's personalities. Sometimes we're going to be crabby. Sometimes we are going to be spontaneously excited and just loving life. And other times it's just going to be a normal day. And then you have those extremes where you're totally heartbroken or you're extremely ecstatic. And then it's like, okay, I'm just chilling. All of the ups and downs that comes with life. But you've got to be willing to do it together. Experience it as a benefit for your marriage. And most importantly, remember to honor your transformation. Go out, spend time with your family, love on your spouse, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.